Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss about the decimal. Right? We have studied in earlier classes also that about the decimal. So we'll see a number whose whole number part and the fraction part is separated by a decimal point. Right? So we'll see. We represent this decimal by dot. Suppose we have a number like 24.53. Right? So this one is the whole part and this one is the fractional part. So this whole part and fractional part are divided by this, is separated by this point. So this one is for decimal point. This one is for decimal point. This one is decimal point. And we read this as 24.53. So this fractional part we read separately and this whole part we read combinedly. So it is for 24.53. So this decimal point separate the whole part and fraction part the separately. This is what the decimal number is. This is how we write the decimal number. We'll take more examples on this. Like any number is there, 124.537. Right? There are three digits after decimal and this one is 124. So this part on the left side of the decimal, this is whole part and this side it is the fractional part. So this we read as separately and this number we can read as 124.537. Now we'll see the place values of the any decimal number. So in whole part there will be the number places according to the Indian system. For example, this is 1's place, this one is the 10's place and the third one is the 100th place. And here similarly on the right side of the decimal, this number, this place we call as 10th place. This place we call as 10th place. This one is 100th place. 100th place. This one is the 100th place. And this one is the 1000th place. This one is the 1000th place. The value of 10th place is 1 by 10. 1 by 10. Or we can say this one is equal to 0.1. It means the digit after just decimal. So that place is called as 10th place. Then second, this one is 100th place. 100, the value of 100 is 1 by 100 and that is equal to 0.01. And 1000. So it is 1 by 1000 and this is equal to 0.001. So 1000 is 1 by 1000. Now we'll see the values of this will be what? 1 into 100, so it is 100, 2 into 10, so 20, and this 4 into 1, so 124 point. This one is 510, 510 that means for 5 by 10, so it is equal to 0.5. 3 by 100, so 0.003, and 7 is 7 by 1000, so that is equal to 0.007. Now we will read this as 124.537. So this is what the all about the decimal numbers, right? So you will get to know that the first, the digit after the decimal, the first digit is which place? It is 10th place, 100th place and 1000th place, right? It's just reverse to 1's place, 10th place and 100th place. On decimal, the next point we'll discuss is comparison of decimal. Now before going to comparison of decimal, two important points we need to know is that there is two types of decimal. The first one is the like decimal. And like decimals are what? If the number of digits after the decimal points are equal in any two decimal, so they are called as like decimals. For example, suppose we are having 2.12 and 5.27. Right? So the digits after, number of digits after decimal, like here it is 2 digit after decimal, there are 2, here it is 2 digit and here also in 5.27 there is 2 digit. So these 2 are what? These 2 are the like decimal. It means what? If the number of digits after decimal point are equal, in that case what? It is called as like decimal. The second type of decimal is what? Unlike decimal. Unlike decimal is what? If the number of digits after decimal are different. Like for example, you can say 1.57 and 2.489, right? So here, two digits after decimal point, right? After decimal point, two digits are there, and here after decimal point, three digits are there. Three digits are there. So they are called as unlike decimal, right? We don't need to, suppose, let's take on one more example, like 22.27 and 328.2. Now we'll see the decimal point, the digits after decimal point. Here it is 2 and here it is 1, right? We do not take the decimal point, the number after, before the decimal point. Will not check. Here it is 3. The whole part will not check. Only decimal digits after decimal will check. Digits after decimal is 2 and here it is 4. 1. So they are the unlike decimal. I hope it is clear. Like decimal, if the digits after decimals are same, like here it is 2 and here it is 2 digits, right? So digits after decimal are equal. In that case, it is like decimal. If the digits after decimal are different, in that case, it is unlike decimal. It is unlike decimal. Now we'll see, we can convert that unlike decimal into like decimal. We can convert unlike decimal to like decimal by putting zeros at the end of the number. Like suppose this one is what, 42.27, and here it is 328.2. So if you write this one 42.27, and this, if I write this 328.20. Now if you put zero here, so there is what? There is no change in value of this number. There is no change in the value of this number. So only zero we have put here. Now we'll see. This two are what? This two, there is two digits after the decimal point. And here also there is two digits after the decimal point. That means now these two numbers become the what? Like decimal. Now this two number becomes like decimal. So we can convert any unlike decimal into like decimal. We can convert this unlike to like by putting 0 on the right of the number. So like suppose 1.57 and 2.480. So 489. Now this we can write as 1.570. Now 3 digits and here there is 2.489. So this is also, there is also 3 digits. That means for this, now these two numbers are like decimal. These two numbers are like decimal. Let's take one more example, like 0.12 and 728. Now we'll see this one is the whole number. So we can put here decimal and 20, right? And let's take another example, like suppose 7.2840. Now these two are unlike decimal because here the digits after decimal is 2 and digits after decimal is here is 4. Now we'll see this 2 and 4. So this we can write as 0.1200 and here it is 7.2840. Now this 4 digit and this is 4 digit. That means this 2 becomes now the like. Okay, after knowing the, about like decimal and unlike decimal, we'll discuss the comparison of decimal. So here we have the different questions on a comparison. Now we'll compare this. This is what 2.45 and 3.758. So how we'll compare? So first we'll say the higher place of the number. Higher place here. Here it is 1's place and this one is the 1's place. Now, so the higher place is 1's place and 1's place. So we'll check that the higher place of the number is 1's place and here it is 2 and here it is 3. Right? Here it is 2 and here it is 3. That means this number, the number at higher place is greater, in that case that number would be greater. Right? So this is how we compare. We start with the higher place of the number. Let's see, here it is, higher place is again 1's place. Higher place, 1's place, so 1 and 4. So obviously this would be greater. Then here it is 2 and here it is 3. Then now we'll see the decimal part. We don't need to. So if we get the number at the higher place is smaller or greater, in that case we'll directly put the values. Now if you see that any question is there, then here it is 4.578 and 4.785. Now see this 1's place. Both are equal. Now we'll get the second highest place, that is 10th place. 10th place, here it is 5 and here it is 7. Here it is 7. So this number is greater. So number this 4.785 will be greater than 4.578. Let's see the second next question we have is 25.78 and 25.789. Now the higher place is what? 10th place. Let's say that here it is 2 and here it is 2, so equal. Then once this 5 and 5 equal, then we'll check 7 equal. Now team, we have got equal or same number on the same places. Now here it is 8 and here it is 8 and here it is 9. That is, there is 3 digits, right? 3 digits after decimal and here it is 2 digits. Then what we'll do is just we'll convert these 2 are unlike decimal. These 2 are unlike decimal. In that case, what we'll do is first we'll convert this unlike decimal into like decimal. First we'll convert this unlike decimal to like decimal. How we'll do that? We can put 0 here. Now there is 3 digit and 3 digit. Now these are the what? Like decimals. See, then if you compare 8, right? 2, 5, 7, 7, 8, right? Then you will see this one is 0 and this one is 9. So obviously this 25.789 will be better than 25.780. Let's take another example. Suppose we are having 409.27 and here it is 4.927. Now you see the higher place is what? 100 place, and here in the higher place is what? 4. So there is no higher place, that means 8 and 10 and 100 there is 0. Now we compare this what? 4 and 0. So this would be what? This would be, this one is 409 and this one is 4 point. So obviously this number would be greater. So while comparing the decimal number, first we start by what? Start by the higher place, the number at higher place. If the whole number, whole part is equal, like suppose here it is 25 and 25, whole part are equal, then we'll go to the next place, next smaller place, like that. So if there is, we'll compare that by the digits of the number, or decimal part also we can compare. Here it is 7 and 7, 8, and here it is 9, so 0. So according to this, 9 is greater than 0, so this number will be greater. Suppose any number is there like 0.33 and here it is 0.3, then which number will be greater? So here obviously these two are what? Unlike decimal. So first we'll convert these two into like decimal. So how will you do that? 0.3, here it is 2 digit and here it is 1 digit. So we'll put 0 here. And we'll see this is what? 3 and 3. Now compare the higher place. Higher place is what? 1 space. So 0 and 0. 3. Then 3. 3 and here it is 3 and here it is 0. So obviously 3 is greater than 0. So this 0.33 is greater than 0.30. I hope it is clear to you all the comparison of decimal. Next, we'll discuss the operations on the decimal number. Operations on the decimal number, that means what? Addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So first we'll see the addition of decimal number. How will add? So here the first question, let's take add 2.45, 3.4 and 52. This one is the whole number and this one is the 3.4 and here it is 2.45. So how will add? We'll add the decimal number according to the places, like 1 space to 1 space, 10th place to 10th place, 100th place to 100th place, right? So we'll see here it is 2.45. This one is the decimal, this one is 10th place and this one is the 100th place. Now here it is 3.4. So 3.4 will write like this. Here 4 is a 10th place. So we'll write 3.4, not like 0.34. This one is the wrong, right? So how to write that? That is the place according. So that is what? 3.4. Then next number is 52 only. 52, the whole number. 52. 5 is a 10th place and 2 is a 1st place. So how to write this? 52. And if you want, then you can put here 0 and here also. By converting into like decimal. Now we can add this 3. Add this 3. So here we will get is 5 and here we will get is 8 decimal and here 3, 2, 6 and here it is 8 and here it is 5. So this is what the answer for it is 58.85. This is how we add according to their decimal places. Let's take another question that add 128.45, 4.5 and 0.53, 543. So the first number is 128.45. Right? Second number is 4.5. So we will not write 4.5 like this. We will write according to their place. So 4 is 8 ones place, 4 and this one is 10th place. So 4.5 and here it is 0.543. So we will write that as 0.54 and 800 place. Right? Now this is how we add this. So we can put here 0, 0 and 0. Because there is 3 digit in the last number, or first we can convert this unlike decimal into like, right? So we add this 0, 0, 0 and this 3. So it becomes 3, 5 plus 4 is 9, and here it is what? 5, 5, 10 and 14 and 4 and decimal point here we get a carry. That is what? 8 plus 4 is 12 and 13. Then again carry 1 and this will be 2 plus 1 is 3 and here it is 133.493. So this is how we add the decimal number. First we'll convert that what the number unlike decimal into like decimal and we'll write the numbers according to the place. Now you can one thing you can take as hint that this decimal point are in same places. Decimal is in same places. So according to the place of the number, we'll write the number and after that we'll add the number digits at 10th place to 10 digits at 10th place. Next operation that is subtraction of decimal number. Let's see with the examples. That the first question is subtract 4.35 from the 12.60. So one thing you remind is always that if what we will subtract the smaller number from the greater number. So here greater number is what 12.60. So we'll write that 12.60 minus here is 4.35. So again one thing that will write the number, yeah, we'll write the digits according to their place. So here it is 4 which is at 1's place and 4.35. Now we'll write to subtract this. Here this 0, so we'll take borrow from it and that is what 10 minus 5 plus 5 and as we subtract like this, so here it becomes 5. So 5 minus 3, this becomes 5. 5 minus 3, it is 2. And here it is decimal point. And here 12 minus 2, it is 8. So we get what? 8.25. Answer for this. The next question is 58 minus 49.437. Now we'll see this one is 58. This one is what? 58. So this 58 will write as 58.000. Not like 0.58. We cannot write like this, right? So we'll write according to the number. We write the number according to the places. So we'll write this as 58.000. We have written 3 digits because in second number there is 3 digits. Now we subtract this 49.437. Right? Then we'll see this. Here it is 0, so we take borrow from here, it become 10, then 10, then 10. So this 10 minus 3, 7 is 3. And this one is become 9. So 9 minus 3, it is equal to 6. And here, this also become 9. 9 minus 4 is 5. And here it is decimal, and this becomes 7. Right? So 7, so we need to take borrow from it, 17. This become what? 17. This will be 17. We have taken borrow and this will be 4. So 17 minus 9 is what? It is 8 and here it is 4 minus 4 is 0. So what will be? We need 8.563. This is how we subtract the number. Let's take another example that is 28.002. And here it we have is 4.87. 4.87. So this will not write as 0.487. So we'll write 0 is 87. So we can write here 0 to convert that unlike decimal to like. Now we'll subtract this. 2 minus 0 is 2. Now 0 minus 7 we cannot subtract. So we'll take borrow from here and this will be what? 10 minus 3. 10 minus 7 is 3 and this will be 9. 9 minus 8 is 1 and decimal. This will be 7. 7 minus 4 is 3 and here it is 2. So we get answer 23.132. I hope this three examples are clear to you. Now we'll discuss the third operation of the decimal number, that is multiplication. So we'll see some examples and we'll understand how we multiply the decimal number. So first category in multiplication is the multiplication of a decimal number by a whole number. So how we multiply? Just the normal number we multiply like this, we'll multiply and put the decimal number after getting the product. So we'll see this. Here it is 2.57 into 4. So let's forget the decimal point. Now multiply 257 by 4. So what you get? 4, 7 is 28 and this is 2. 4, 5 is 20 and this is 22. And 2, 4, 2 is 8 and 2. This will be 1028. Now after getting this product, we'll put the decimal. We'll count the decimal point. Here it is 1, 2. It is 2 digit before. The decimal point is 2 digit before. So from right side, we always count from the right side. 2 digit before. It is 1, 2. So we get 10.28. So we get answer as 10.28. Just count 2 digits. So from right side, always take from the right side. It is 2 digit. So 10.28. Let's discuss the another question we have. 8.27 into 12. 8.27 into 12. So 12 we can multiply is 827 into 12. So 12 7 is 84. It will be 8. 12 is 24 and 24 8 is 32. So this one is 2 and here this will get 3 as remainder. Now 12 8 jump, it is 96 and 96 and 3. This should be 99. So we get 9920. Now we'll see there is again 2 digit before. So from right side we count 2 digit, that is 1, 2. So we'll get answer as 99.24. I hope it's clear the decimal number multiplication by whole number. Now we'll see the second category, the multiplication for decimal number by 10, 100 and 1000. We'll see this, just multiply as it is. So how we can multiply 10, 70, 70? Right, or we can write this number with, because there is 10. So we can write the same number 45270, and this is how this is what we get 4527 into 10. Now we count the decimal. Here it is 2 digits, so 1, 2. So what we get is pure 52.70. Answer of this would be 452.70. Then the second next number is 45.27 into 100. So what we get is just write the number and how many zeros are there? 2 zeros. So we can write here 2 zeros. Now put the decimal point 1, 2. 2 digits before, always from the right side. 1, 2. Here we'll get 4527.00, or we can just write this as 4527. Then the multiplication by 1000. 45.27 into 1000. So this will be as 4527. Just write the number and 3 zeros are there. So put the 3 zeros here. Right? So again, 2 digit 1, 2. From right side, just 1, 2. So what you get is 45.270. 45,270 is the answer. Now, one thing you can observe here from these three examples, that if you multiply any number by 10, 100 and 1000, the decimal point would move in the right place according to the number of 0. Let's see here, the question is 45.27. The decimal is equal to, now if you multiply this 10 with this, so what you get is this decimal point move at one place to the right. So here we are getting 452.70, and here we get 2 digits, so this decimal point moved 2 places to the right, and here it is 3 zero, so this decimal point place or move 3 places to the right. So this is how what we get from these 3 examples is, if you multiply any number by the 10, 100 and 1000, so that decimal point moved to the right side according to the number of 0. So 1 0 is there, that means one place decimal point move. If 2 0 is there, so 2 place move, and 3 0 is there, that means 3 place it will move to the right side. If 4 0 is there, it means it will move to the 4 places to the right of the number. Right? Let's discuss the next is decimal point multiply decimal number. Right? We'll see this. Here it is 2.7 into 0.07. Now multiply this 7. Leave the decimal number now, multiply the numbers. Then after getting product, we'll put the decimal point. Now we'll see 7 is 49 it is, then 4, and here we get as 7 to the 14 and 14 and 4 it is 18. Okay. Now if you read the 0, so that becomes 0, 0, and for 0 also it will be 0. That means what will get here? 9, 8, 1. And 0. Right? Now we count the decimal numbers. Decimal numbers. How many digits are there? Right? So here in this number 2 digit before, and in this number 1 digit before. So total how many digit before? It is 3. Here it is 2 and here it is 1. So that becomes 3 digit before. We'll put the decimal 3 digit before from the right side. Always take from the right side. So here it is 1, 2 and 3. So this would be 0.189. I hope it is clear. Here it is 2 digit and here it is 1 digit. So total 3 digits. Then we will see the last question of it. 8.72 into 2.7. How will say this? 8.72 into 2.7. So first we multiply by 7. As we multiply the normal numbers. So we will see this one is 7 to the 14. 7 to the 14, 1. 7, 7 to the 49 and 1 is 15. 5, 7, 8 to 56 and 56. Plus 5 is 61. Now we will not put the decimal here. After getting the final product, we will put the decimal. So read the table. 2 2s are 4 here, and 2 7s are 14, and here 1, 2, 8 is 16 plus 1, 17. So here, after adding this 2, we will add this, and this is what? 4, 4, and here it is 5, now 7, 13, 1, and here it is 2. Now this is the final product of this 872 into 27. Now we put the decimal. Here it is 1 digit before and here it is 2 digits. So 1 and 2. That is complete 3 digit before. Now 1, 2, 3. So what we get is 23.544. I hope the multiplication of decimal number is clear to you. Let's discuss the last operation, that is division of decimal. So if the first case we'll see is the division of any decimal number by 10, 100 and 1000. So as we will multiply the number by 10, 100 and 1000, in that case the decimal point were moving what to the right. Now in division it moves to the left side of the number, right? So according to number of 0, as number of 0 is there, so that much place it moves to the left of the number. So here it is what? 0.04. So this will get as 0.004. There is 1 0, so this decimal point moved to the one place to the left. So what we get is 0.004. Now in this question, here it is 252.54. 252.54 divided by 100. Here how many zeros are there? 2 zeros. So we get is as 2.5254. This we can get by the normal division also. Like suppose we divide it, what we get? 252.54 divided by 100. So first we'll read 200 puja, so this becomes 200, and divided by it is 52, and this which is 5. Now decimal point, here we are crossing the decimal point, so we'll put here the decimal, then 100, 5 chan. So we'll get 500, and this will be 25, and here we'll take what? 4. Now we'll see, this one is what? It is 200. So it is 200, and this one is 54. Now we can put 0 as the decimal point is there before. Now 100, 5, so this is equal to 500, and this will get 40, remainder, and here we put 0, and this 100, 4, so that becomes 400, and here we get remainder as 0. So you can see here the answer we are getting is 2.5254. So if the decimal number of 0, the decimal point move to the left side on the number if we divide any number by 10, 100 and 1000. So what will be the answer for this 1, 2, 3. There is no number, so this will be the decimal is at the last. So it will move 1, 2, 3. So this will answer for this will be what 5.430. 5.430. This also we can get by which I suppose 5430 divided by 1000. So by fraction term we can convert this into decimal point. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So this would be 5.430. Right? So decimal point move in division on the left side of the number according to number of 0. Right? Now we'll see question division a whole decimal number by a whole number. So how will divide it? We can divide it that like 0.25 by 5. So here we can divide it simply by simplification 5 ones are 50 decimal and 5 zeros are 5 5 ones. So what we get is 0.05. Or we can solve it by another method, that is what just divide it 0.5. So 0.25 we can write as 25 by 100. Now divided by 5 we can write as 5 by 1. So this would be what 25 by 100. And this we convert this division into multiplication. That's where reciprocal of the second fraction. Reciprocal of second fraction. Whenever we convert the division into multiplication, we what reciprocal the number of second fraction. That is, it would become 5 by 1 converted into 1 by 5. Now we'll see this 5 1 ja and 5 5 ja. What you get is 5 by 100, and this we can write as 0.05. This we can write as 0.05. This is the answer for this. So we can simply divide it by whole number, or we can solve like this also. Right? Let's see the another number, decimal number divided by decimal number. So how do you convert, write it? Just first we'll convert that decimal into fraction, like 4.28. This we can write as 428 divided by 100, and here it is division, and this will also convert this also. It is 240 divided by, how many digits are there? 4, 3 digits, so we write divided by 1000. Now we'll convert this 428 by 100 and convert this division into multiplication and reciprocal. Reciprocal means just opposite. So 1000 numerator become denominator and denominator become numerator. So this one is 240. Now so we can simplify this. This one is the double, 428 is double of 240. So this one and this 21. Now 20 and 20 cancel out. So what will be is 2 into 10. What is remaining? This 2 into 10. So this is equal to 20. The answer for this is 20. So I think this with this example we have completed the division of decimal number. So with this we have completed the whole part of the operation of the decimal number. Thank you.